Federally, the latest poll conducted by Nanos Research shows that Pierre Poilievre continues to be the top choice as prime minister and hit a level not reached by any conservative leader since 2013. Joining me now is Nik Nanos, the founder and chief data scientist at Nanos Research. Nik, thank you as always for joining us this morning, a rainy Saturday morning where we are at least.
Yeah, I guess a bit rainy for the Liberals too once we start going through these numbers.
I'm not saying you, but a lot of people raining on their parade right now. The numbers, holy cow.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you look at the ballot numbers, right? And, you know, when a government's behind or any party's behind by 10 points, you go, that's not very good. 15 points, that's bad. 20 points, Roger?
Oh, start placing your bets.
Well, you know, you can see that the conservatives led by Pierre Poilievre at 43%, Liberals back 20 points at 23, NDP 21, that's within the margin of error. And, you know, it speaks to, you know, where the conservatives and Liberals are at. You know, the other thing is, Roger, mm-hmm. what happened in the last couple of weeks, PharmaCare, the Liberals and NDP announced a PharmaCare thing. I think maybe they were hoping that would move the numbers. Not so much. Actually, the conservatives are up 3 points in the last 4 weeks. So if the Liberals or the New Democrats thought that there'd be any kind of bonus out of introducing this PharmaCare program that was very important to keep the parliamentary coalition alive, nothing out of that for sure right now.
Any indicators long term that this might be just a blip or just the conservatives continue to dominate?
Well, the big question is what are the conservatives going to do to mess things up, I guess? And I think that's probably what the Liberals...
It is theirs to lose right now, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, I think what the Liberals have to do is that somehow there's something learned about Pierre Poilievre, or he makes a mistake, or someone close to him makes some type of major blunder in order to change this trend line. But, you know, the thing is that since last August, the conservatives have been in the driver's seat, and it looks like there's just nothing that can change this right now. So I'm not sure what the Liberals and New Democrats can do other than hope that there's something that happens to Pierre Poilievre that may make some people hesitate who are currently supporting the Conservatives.
And the NDP, they must have their eyes on second place right now.
Yeah, you know, the thing is if the NDP numbers tie the Liberals or move ahead of the Liberals, I think that's when we get into, you know, election territory, because, you know, the thing is, it'll be kind of like those, you know, piranha tanks, right? You know, like start feeding on the Liberals, the New Democrats and the Conservatives if the NDP start going up.
Okay. And also talking about standard of living and the future of it. What are Canadians thinking about that for the next generation?
They're not feeling very well. You know, about 2 out of every 3 Canadians think that the future generations will have a lower standard of living. You know, only 11% think that the standard of living for the next generation will be higher. That means people are negative by a margin of 6-1. And, you know, Roger, when you look at the trend line, you can see that, you know, realistically for, you know, the last 2 years, especially, Canadians have been especially pessimistic about the future. Probably speaks to why they're so grumpy at the incumbent government, the Liberals right now, because, you know, they don't have a lot of optimism. And there's probably just a lot of frustration as Canadians are just struggling to pay the bills and thinking, man, you know, will my kids and grandkids, you know, what type of economy will it be for them? Where will they get jobs? And will we have the same standard of living in the future that we have today?